Rich text editors can be quite challenging to implement natively. And this complexity increases when you need to support multiple platforms like Android, iOS, and web. The reality is that there are many good libraries for handling rich text, but these libraries typically only work for the web. This is where DOM components come in. DOM components is a new feature introduced in Expo SDK 52 that allows you to seamlessly integrate React web components into your Expo app. The main purpose of DOM components is to enable developers to incrementally migrate from web to native. Beyond that, they also allow you to integrate any web library in your native app. Even if it's just a single view, this can be extremely useful for implementing complex features more quickly and consistently across platforms. A rich text editor is the perfect use case for considering DOM components. In today's video, we'll integrate Lexical, a JavaScript web text editor framework developed by Meta, which will work and look consistent across Android, iOS, and web. Let's see the demo. Here we have the final result of what we're going to build today. So this is a rich text editor. This is the component that comes from Lexical. And let me show you. You can check it out at lexical.dev. And the cool thing is that it's open source, so you can contribute as well if you want to. Develop my meta so you can be assured that this is a reliable text editor. So a rich text editor usually will allow to do many things. This is great, for example, when you're creating a post or if you have an application that relies on having a lot of text and you want to allow users to have maybe bold text or underline, even center. And if we start playing around with this, for example, if I want to start typing some bold text in here on each platform, you can see that I can center the text. And if I go to iOS, it's basically the same thing. We can start changing this to bold, underlined, and maybe combined all of these properties that we can do, even center. And here, whereas you can see DOM components really shine because we have the same UI across all platforms, same behavior, same functionality, and you're going to see that it's very easy to implement. So let's dive in. First thing that I want to do is create a new Expo app, and I'll create this one inside my examples folder using bun. By running create expo app and then passing the name, which is going to be rich text editor example. The app is ready, so let's cd into this folder and open this in my editor. By the way, another advantage is that this is going to work on Expo Go as well, which is quite beneficial to develop faster. The first requirement, guys, is going to be having SDK 52. The second thing is going to be installed React Native Web View. Since DOM components at the end of the day are a web view, we need to have this pair dependency. So let's go ahead and install it. All right, now we should be good to start using DOM components. Let's start the server and I'll run this on my simulator. I'll reload. All right, and here we have our app. And just like that, we can start creating DOM components. So I'll just go ahead and create a new component called hello.tsx and then paste a web view. And even we are passing properties. This is a DOM component, and the only thing that we need to do is add this line, use DOM, so that we can start using DOM components. So let's go ahead and save this. Now let's go to the index screen. I'll replace everything for an empty tag, and in here, I'll add my component. Let's hit save, and there we have it. And this is how you can start integrating DOM components. As you can see, it's very easy and you can start playing around with whatever you want to do in here. And as soon as I save the changes, you can see it reflected on screen. So now I'll stop the server and let's start implementing Lexical. I'll install Lexical, React, and Lexical by running bun install. So let's hit enter. Okay, so that's quick. Let's start the server again. I'll say bun start. And from here, we can start importing Lexical and all the things that we need to do in our web view. So what I'll do now is just drag and drop a folder which contains my Lexical component. Since I don't wanna spend a lot of time teaching you how to use Lexical, just to see the example. But let's see an overview of how this component looks like. So I have this Hello DOM, which is a component that implements Lexical. And I just took this example from the Lexical documentation, so it's not like super complicated. We are importing all these plugins and importing as well this styles.css. This is another thing. You can have a styles.css file and adding styles to your web view and change them and reload the application, and you can see how it looks in real time. So this component basically is implementing a web text editor. We can define some configuration for Lexical, but the editor looks like this. It's a simple React component. We are using the component in here, passing the configuration. We are using divs. We're using other plugins like toolbar plugin, and that's it. That's all my component. So from here, a couple of things to notice is that we can pass properties to DOM components. In this case, I'm passing two functions that are setters to set the state of the editor. And then we can get this state on the native side. And from there, you can do whatever you need, like saving the state of the editor, doing a fetch request, whatever. So let's go ahead and go back to the index page. And in here, instead of having this DOM component, I'll import my editor. Now, as we saw previously, this is expecting two setter functions. So let's go ahead and define them. In this case, I will have two variables using useState. The first one is going to be the plain text from the editor, and the other one is going to be the editor state. Since the editor state, it's like a very complex data structure, sometimes you only want to have the plain text. So in this case, we will have two, because in some other cases, you might want to save the editor state and persist it across user sessions and things like that. So now let's pass this to the component and hit save. Let's reload the app. All right, and just like that, we are able to see the text editor. And from here, I can start typing and we can start editing, like adding a bold text, center, and maybe switching the hello to be, I don't know, something like that. And that's it. Now let's access the state from the text editor. So just to test, let's see the plain text in the console. And let me open the console, clear it, and add a new character. And this is the plain text. Now, notice that we are in the native side, right? So in here, I can start using my regular text from React Native and add my plain text. Okay, and my text is off the screen. So a quick fix for that would be to go to the tab layout, and then on the index screen, I can say header shown. Okay, and that is going to push everything. We can change the title to be Rich Text Editor and hit save. Cool, so now I'll just close this. To show you as well how the editor state looks, let's put it in the console, and this is how it looks. You can, of course, learn more about this on the lexical documentation, but as I mentioned before, this is a very complex data structure that stores the state of the editor. So if you have bold text, if you have a specific format, everything is going to be inside this tree-like structure. All right, so let's test this again. I'll go to my view, hello, and as you can see, as soon as I type, we are getting the logs as well as the plain text. So from here, you can do whatever you need, but also we can open this on Android. Let's open this on web as well. Here it is, which I will just reload. This is how it looks. So from here, it's just a matter of styling and applying your specific business logic, but just wanna mention that this is working fine on all the platforms. And that brings us to the end of this video, guys. While we generally recommend sticking to native functionality for best performance and integration within your app, there are certain use cases like implementing a rich text editor where leveraging tools like DOM components can be incredibly valuable. By using DOM components, you can achieve a consistent, fast implementation across platforms, saving both time and effort while delivering a seamless user experience. And then in the future, you can do a native implementation for each platform, but that is going to take time. In the meantime, you already have this text editor that works everywhere. So I hope this demonstration of integrating Lexical into your Expo app has inspired you to explore similar approaches for complex features. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more tips and tutorials. I'll see you in the next one.